plugs. Now then, as we know, that's only one half of the story, isn't it? What about the device that they connect into? Yes, I'm talking about sockets. Are we going to do a video on sockets? It would be silly not to, wouldn't it? Okay, so we're going to be getting into that right now. We're going to be having a look at a few sockets for plugs to connect into. What channel is this? Oh, you might need to look at this. That is a single socket, flush mount, 13 amp British Standard 1363. Bit of an old one, that's because you can tell by the fact that the fixing screws for this one are down the bottom and up the top. Modern day sockets like this would have the fixing screws to the left and to the right. This one's a bit back in the day. Let's flip it over and have a look. You can see on the back of there, then we've got all the detailings. Oh, look, it's an MK. So what about that then? So as you can see up the top, it says 13 amp, 250 volts. Although, you know, you'd be lucky to get 250 volts in your house. This is the maximum power voltage handling. It would normally be around about 240 volts. Just down there, we see it says British Standard 1363. It's made by MK and, of course, made in England. So there you go. Live there, live active phase, hot, call it what you like. Neutral there, and is your earth connection up the top there. Okay, like I say, this is a bit of an old one because it got the fixings down the bottom and up the top instead of to the left and to the right, as it is on most modern day sockets. Let me whip that zoom right out. So there were other sort of sockets available, and what we've looked at there, although you wouldn't wire this and use it, you probably could, but I wouldn't recommend it. Okay, this socket probably does work perfectly well because this was in the house when we moved in, and the only reason I removed it was the fact that it didn't have a switch on it. Okay, apart from that, it was still fully functional when I removed it. So let's wind things on a bit then and have a look at a double socket. And this one does have switches on it. I will just tweak that camera up a bit, and it looks a bit like this. This once again is MK, and this is the older style Logic that they done. Whack. Okay, it looks a bit like that. There's still thousands of these all over the UK, still in use. Okay, this was later replaced by the Logic Plus range. Okay, two switches. Look, what, a switch for each socket. Okay, so there you go. This can be flush mounted, although having said that, this one does have a surface mounting box on it. Unused, okay, this socket and box are unused, they are brand new, never been used. They were going to be, this was going to be installed, but I kind of figured at the time, because the Logic Plus range had already been launched, I should keep this one and put it in the collection, and have it as an unused socket, okay. Because in a few years' time, there's not going to be many of these around which are unused. And of course, as per the opening shots, I do have a plug for it. Oh, look, it's MK as well. Okay, I do have to point out here, I'm not paid by MK to do this, okay? And because of that, I do have to say that there are other brands available. It's just that I like MK stuff because it's really well made. And there we go. So, you know, there's the plug and there's the socket. And you can tell that this is an older plug because of that logo on the plug. Okay, the bang up to date MK logo isn't like that. It's actually in a square. And it just says the M and the K. And the M and the K in the modern day logo doesn't stretch to the circle like that. Okay, it's just letter M and letter K in the middle and looks pretty monotonous and boring. I do actually prefer that logo. Okay, so, as you can see then, and we've got a plug in there. And you could also put another one in the other side, of course. Not to mention a whole variety of different adapters you can get in there, like two ways and three way adapters. And the times I've seen it done where there's a three way adapter in there and three way adapter in there, all plugs hanging out. Okay, shouldn't do it. Okay, those adapters are for temporary use only, should not be permanently used. If you are using them on a permanent basis, this means that you have not got enough sockets and you should consider updating your electrical system. So we got something like that then. We had single sockets. Where's that one gone? Like this. These all were obviously available with switches on. This one, it was also available down here. You had little square red windows. And when you turn the switch on, they would light up. They were neon indicators. Okay, they were available. This one obviously doesn't have it, but when these sockets were for sale, they used to have like two little square red windows down the bottom there. And when you turn it on, they would obviously light up to say that the respective socket is turned on. Okay, very handy late at night in the dark room. You could actually see lights glowing away there to say that the sockets are turned on, so you can then turn them off, save power, and for fire safety and all that lot. So, in the opening shot, we saw a plug like this, round pins on it. 15 amp bridge standard 546. Yes, I do have a socket for it because it would be silly not to have a socket for that, and also. If I didn't have a socket for it, to include that in the opening shot. Okay, what I'm about to show you is the first 15 amp British Standard 546 socket I ever got. Okay, and it did spur me on to buying things like this. There it is. Okay. As I said, in with this one, they were available with neon indicators, and this one does have such an indicator on it, it's just down there. Okay, instead of this being square, it's actually flat down the sides but rounded at the top of the bottom. There is a neon indicator in there and it does still work. Switch, okay, and round pins. That there's 15 amp British Standard 446 and there's the respective plug for it. Oh, look at that, they're both MK once again. Ooh. So, we're going to get our plug then and just plop that straight in there. Like that, it's a gorgeous. Glide, that just glides in there most wonderfully. Lovely smooth action on that. Okay, as you can see, even though we've got that ear on the side of the plug, you've still got the neon indicator there. So when you turn switch, that will light up. It obviously won't because this is not connected. Once again, these could be flush fitted or as I've done it here, as a surface mount box. Interestingly, this box is a dual accessory box because right next to that. You can see a 5 amp unswitched socket there. And yes, I do have a respective plug for it. In there it goes. Like that. Okay. And of course, like that. So there we are. What else can I show up in front of the camera then? Well, with sockets like of this particular vintage. Okay, and you can actually get it in the 13 amp variety as well, but I haven't got one here to show at the moment, which is a little annoying and a little embarrassing. But you can get surface mount ones where they're surface mount only. With these types, you can either flush mount them to the wall or provide a surface mount back box like it is here and assemble it in that way and then screw this whole assembly to the wall. This socket, back box is a used unit because it's been punched out there and you have had all the wires going in back there. This box originally was actually found inside a central heating unit and it would have had 5 amp socket on there and then in place where this was there was actually a flex outlet with just a hole in the middle with a flex coming out of it. Okay, so this box was inside a heating unit, central heating unit, and I've salvaged it. You can tell by the heat caused inside the central heating unit that it's actually started to crack the box there. That focus went then. If I just put that on, how do I lock this onto manual focus? Right, it's locked on manual focus now. So you can see on this box that the heat caused by the central heating system has actually caused this box to start cracking and splitting. I'm not sure if it's like it underneath. Yes, it is right there. Okay. So that would have been installed in that central heating unit back in the 70s. That I do know. But that central heating system was removed from service, and that's how I come to get hold of this box. And then I just got two of my accessories and put that in there to make a nice little unit for display purposes. Just like that. But like I was saying, 5 amp and 15 amp sockets, the British Standard 546, that are surface mount only. They were available. And look a bit like this. Whack. As you can see, ramping's once again with a switch. Straight in there, we have the 15 amp plug. I have reason to believe that this socket is a replica. Okay, it wasn't made back in the day because you can tell how that is, because the plug is like a nice cream colour, like an ivory colour, but this socket is like a hard white, rather much like that kind of white. Okay, as you can see, those two sort of whites, more or less the same colour. Okay, but the plug, which is back in the day, is a nice little cream ivory colour. Okay, that's how you can tell. And if I bring this back in once again, you can tell that this is back in the day because it's like a cream ivory colour. But this one's quite a modern day, well, I wouldn't say replica, but it's a bit more up to date than what this one was. Okay, so that's how you can tell that this socket is like a remake. Okay, because how hard white the shade of white is. Okay, so as you can see with this one, you can't flush mount it because it's a one piece unit. Okay, what you see there's not the socket with a back box. Okay, this part here is the enclosure to hide up all the screws and terminal screws and whatnot. The socket is actually this back part. Okay. And then this whole lot would have been screwed to the wall just like that. Or if you really wanted, you could have got an additional buttress. Okay, which finishes it off. It's got like a radiused curve on it. And you would have put that to the wall, screwed that to the wall, and then fixed this to the buttress. And it would have made it stick out the wall a bit further. But it finished it off. It gave it a nice radiused corners and whatnot. It really finished it off and made it look really nice and smart. But a lot of people didn't bother with the back box, the buttress. They just screwed this straight to the wall, which at that point in time was perfectly acceptable to do. And there we go. Terminals on the back then. Let's have a look in there. I've got that on manual focus, haven't I? Let's put it back on autofocus to sharpen it up a bit because this is full HD. Don't forget on Wayne's Electrical. Right, AC only then. Okay, 15 amp, 250 volts. That's its maximum voltage, of course. You will obviously wouldn't have 250 volts going into this unless you were really lucky. Oh, look, it's MK once again. Other brands were available. This one, it is actually reconfigured. Well, not you can't buy the bits and put it in here. Once it's made in the factory like this, that's it. But these were also available as a double pole option. This one's configured for single pole because there's the terminal right there for the live. Okay, the neutral one will be around here somewhere. There it is, there's a neutral one down there, and there's the earth one up there. If this was a double pole one, that hole would be empty, and your live terminal would be over here in this hole. Okay, and then that would obviously be the neutral or something like that. Yeah, actually, that would stay as the live. That would be the neutral one for the double pole. So that would stay as it is. The neutral would be in there, and then that hole down there would be empty. Okay, because that obviously there connects straight into the respective socket tube, and then the live socket tube, and then go up through the switch, and then there's a live terminal there. This is a British Standard 546. I'd like to seem to think it says it in there somewhere. Interestingly, it doesn't. But I can reliably inform you that this socket is manufactured the British Standard 546. Okay, because it says it on the plug in the middle there. British Standard 546. I can get on that for you. There you go. British Standard 546. And of course, if that plug goes in that socket, then that obviously means that that socket is the British Standard 546 as well. Did they do a 5 amp one? Oh, yes, they did. That's the 15 amp one then. Here's the 5-amp one. Now this one is a used unit. Okay, I've got this on salvage. And interestingly, this 5-amp socket came from the same place as that 15-amp switch socket with the neon on it. There it is. As you can see, this is a bit back in the day because it's that nice cream ivory colour. Okay, used because it's had knockouts taken on it. Rather much styled in exactly the same way as the 15-amp equivalent. Okay, all the terminals are rather much in the same place. British Standard 546 once again, and there's a respective plug for it. In there it goes. Okay. Did they do a 2-amp one of this? I don't know, I've never seen one. Okay, just no, stop, hold it. Just hold it right there a moment. What a blooper. MK did make a 2-amp socket. You've even flipping bought one. Okay, you even showed it on the previous channel. My goodness me, what a flipping blooper that is. Right, have yourself a look at this. Okay then, right, just a little add-in section there, bit of a blooper. Yes, MK did actually, in fact, make a 2-amp version of this. That's a 15-amp. There's the 5-amp. Okay, and of course, here's the little wee 2-amp one. Yes, there it is. So there we go. Just a little add-in section because I made a bit of a blooper there. And of course, here's the respective plugs. There's the 15-amp one in there. Like that. There's the 5-amp one in there like that. And of course, here's the little wee 2-amp one with its little wee plug in there like that. Little wee one. So there we go. So MK did make a 2-amp version of these. There it is. Now, how did that mistake happen then? Okay, I'm supposed to know all my flipping plugs and sockets, aren't I? Well, I should tell you how that happened. These accessories that I've got here, I'll just put this one aside a moment. Right, all of these, there they are. They're in one box. Now, it would be some years later. Oh, hold on a moment. Right, all of that would be in one box, and it would be some years later that I managed to acquire this. And because the box these are in is full up, this had to get put in another box. And consequently, when I was doing a full HD reshoot, this accidentally got left out. Hence my saying in that video, as a bit of a blooper, that when I got all the accessories out for high def reshoot on Wayne's Electrical, this got left out. And well, that was a bit of a blooper. Now, originally, what I was going to do was just going to, after this video, with the one that I've just paused, I was going to drop it in as like a correction stub, and it would have gone out about half an hour after the video, which has just been paused. But for those, just coming onto the channel, stumbling across that little correction stub, it would have looked a bit silly. Like, why have you done that? What video did you mess up on? And I kind of figured I've got the original footage. Let's fire up Tasty Edits, split the footage, drop this in, correct the situation, in the bag, one video, thank you very much, and then we can just crack on with it. Okay, so that's it, me explaining that one, yes, I did flipping screw up in that video. Number two, there's the correction right there. I do own one, they did make one, and all of that, and there it is. Put it in one video, stitch a whole flipping lot back together, bang it out. Okay, so there's that little blooper sorted out then. Okay, right. That video you were watching, let's go back to it. What about plugs like this then? Two pin 5-amp. This is British Standard 372. Did they do a socket for it? Once again, Yes, they did. And I do have one. These are like super rare. Okay, the one that I've got, I'm just about to show you, it's the only one I've ever seen. I've never seen another one. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to zip off for a little break. When we come back, we'll have a look at that. Okay, the socket for this plug. Okay, so just do stay there. We'll have a look at that after the break. I need to pop off and have a cup of tea. Just bear with me a minute. Okay, thanks for coming back after the break then. What we're going to be looking at now is the socket for that plug. That's a 5 amp, 2 pin, British Standard 372. Okay, so let's pull that zoom back a bit then, just a little wee bit. There we go. So there's the plug, where's the socket for it then? Well, like I say, this is the only one I've ever seen. I actually found this in a rubbish skip. Okay, it's well, it almost escaped me, but I have managed to find one. It was in a rubbish skip, and quite why they're throwing it out, I don't know, because I don't think it's ever been used. There's no knockouts that's been taken on it. Are you ready for this? This is a nice little tasty socket as well. It's really clean and tidy in smart condition. It's got a little bit of paint on it, but I've never been able to get it off, and I'm not going to have a go at it either, just in case I damage it, because it's right near one of the knockouts, and if I accidentally smash that out, then that'd be a little unfortunate. So here we go then with a socket for that plug. Whack! There it is. Okay, that looks a little odd to today's standards, but you can probably imagine back in the day that people had these in the houses. And there we are. A funny little interesting thing about this is that plug can go in that socket either way around. So let me just lower that camera down a bit. Okay, that plug can go in that socket either way around. But the funny thing is, there is a funny little way to prevent that from happening. And it's this, basically. There's the two pins on the plug, and there's your hole where the power cord would come out. Okay. You put your plug in the socket, come here, you disobedient the plug, go in the socket like that. There's your switch, and there is the flex outlet hole, okay, where your power cord would come out. Operate the switch, no worries whatsoever. Take the plug out, and because I said that this plug can go in the socket either way around, there it is. Okay, and now the flex outlet is on this side, but what do you notice? That flex coming out of there would go in front of the switch, and you would not be able to turn that switch on because it would foul the hole where the power cord comes out. Okay, as you can see there, you wouldn't be able to operate the switch because the power cord would stop it from operating. The only way around that would be to take the plug out, rather naughty, turn the switch on, and then shove the plug in. Okay, and then that would get around it, but you shouldn't really do that because this appliance, which is wired to this plug, if it started up the moment you put that in there, not only would it damage the plug, it would also damage the socket. Okay, so you shouldn't do that. These sockets, they can't be used anymore in today's domestic settings because this socket does actually not have any shutters in it. All of the sockets that I've shown so far do have shutters in, okay, but this one doesn't. So, okay, so you know, if you find someone that's selling a pile of these, either used or brand new in the box, don't think about buying them and install them in your house or shed or anywhere like that because they don't meet today's electrical safety standards anymore. Okay, all the sockets that I've already shown do have shutters in. Okay, this one's got shutters in. So's that. And of course, right from the outset, British Standard 1363 has always had shutters in it. Okay, you can't see them in there, they're a bit dark coloured. But there we are, you see, shutters. But this one, it doesn't have. Oh, I'm sorry about that. This one doesn't have shutters in it. I'm not sure we'll be able to get the light in there. But trust me on this when I say that there isn't any shutters in there. Okay, let's look on the back then. As you could quite well imagine, there's only two terminals on the back of this one. No earthing terminal. 5 amp, 250 volts maximum voltage then. It's made by MK once again. Down here it says AC only. Okay, because there was a point in time where, shall I say, in the UK, certain regions were transferring over to alternating current, and some places were still on direct current. Because of that, sockets like this could not handle direct current if you attempted to wire this into a direct current circuit. All would be well, and you put your plug in, okay, you turn it on, but the problem arises when you turn the switch off. Okay, if this is tugging a sufficient amount of current, what would happen is as you turn that switch off, it would not be able to break a direct current load and it would fizz over and get hot and burn up in there. Okay, instead of the switch just opening, it would fizz across in there and start crackling and buzzing. There might even be loads of smoke coming out of it and goodness knows what else. Okay, and yeah, because this hasn't got shutters on it, if that started doing it and you attempted to draw that out, you could actually pull that plug out of there and have big old arcs coming out of there, coming out of these holes going to the pins. Okay, you could actually stretch a nice big arc out of that socket. And there you are. Okay, if that was shuttered, you'd probably have drawn it out of there in big arcs, and then the shutters would snap closed and that would extinguish the arcs. But by that time, the plug and socket have been damaged. Okay, so sockets like this and all the ones that I've shown in this video, they are AC only. And there we go. There were particular sockets available at the time that were suited for direct current, but the switching unit on them would be much more beefy. It'd be a bladed switch, okay, and there'd be two blades in there. And when you operate that, instead of the separation gap being only like 2 or 3 millimeters, as like it is on this, the separation gap would be, a good inch, okay, or 25 millimeters. And that would be afforded by the fact that the switch would have two big blades on it, and the electricity would have to come from one terminal, up a blade, across to the other blade, down that blade, and into another terminal. And those two terminals would then give a combined separation gap of at least an inch, and direct current could not get across a gap that big. So we looked at a nice little selection of sockets in this video then. From surface mount ones like this to flush mount ones like this, and in certain cases, sockets where they could be surface mounted or flush mounted, as like this. I'm just trying to adjust that camera a bit for the closing shots. Okay, so there we go. Now, at the beginning of the video, I did say that sockets like these, okay, these are surface mount only. And they were available in the British Standard 13631, and I didn't have one to show. Well, I've just managed to find one. There it is. Okay, as you can see, this is sort of like the surface mount equivalent of this. Okay, because you've got your cover there, which protects all the terminals and that. And then this bit at the back is the actual socket. Okay, if I get the light in there and zoom in on that for you, you will see that this is a 13 amp 250 volt one, British Standard 1363, although I don't think it says it in there. No, it doesn't, funnily enough. Oh, it does, my bad. That circuit down there then says Brit Pat, and then in the middle is British Standard 1363. So yes, it does. There it is then. Okay, so British pattern and then British Standard 1363, made in England. And as you could have quite well imagine, the plugs for these were also made in brown. Okay, I've already done a video on those, funnily enough. And there's a respective plug, and that will obviously just go straight in there. No worries whatsoever. Okay, so I think I've covered it all. Well, in the domestic range anyway. Okay, we won't do industrial plugs in this video. But yes, sockets then where they could either be flush mounted like this or surface mounted like this. Okay, and then sockets which were surface mount only. Okay, so I'm just going to leave all that lot there as a closing shot. There's all my plugs and goodness knows what else. Okay, I'd like to say thanks for tuning in for watching this one because, you know, we've had a whole pile of plugs up in front of the camera. Oh, look, there's another one there. Yeah, oh, look, brown plugs. Remember what I was saying about brown plugs? There you are. It's all there. And there we have it. Oh, look, there's even a few more there. Let's put those in as well. So, yes, I'm out of here then.